The White House, thanks very much. Back with our panel now. Adolfo, I suppose one of the dangers here politically for the president is that tariffs like this will exact a cost on the president's own voter base. Is this President Trump's negotiating strategy for the United States dangerous for his voters?
Not at all, because it's going to bear fruit. The president used the same language regarding Mexico. You could have inserted Mexico some months ago, and we have made significant progress. Canadian foreign minister cut a trip short from Europe and returned because of this situation of the urgency involved. I really firmly believe that if you look at the president's words carefully, he says, "Oh, I don't know where it will end." He didn't say this was necessarily going to be the end of the negotiation. I think at the end, the president wants fair trade, better trade, understands, and is supportive of free trade on the fixes that are necessary. I will say this quickly, Jim. I worked on these trade agreements in the Bush administration and have been around them for a very long period of time. Nobody was talking about these fixes, and now everybody agrees they're necessary until Donald Trump was elected president. So I think his negotiating tactics are legitimate and will bear fruit.
Jen, there was quite a remarkable moment today. The Toronto Star reported remarks that the president said he wanted off the record. According to the Star's source, Trump told Bloomberg that he has not made any compromises at all with Canada in these trade talks. He suggested he was scaring Canadians by threatening them. President Trump reported saying, quote, off the record, Canada is working their ass off, the president's words, and every time we have a problem with a point, I just put up a picture of a Chevrolet Impala here. Now, the president is now complaining that these off the record comments came out. He said the following just a short time ago.
It said, off the record, and I said something strong, but it's my belief. In the end, it's okay, because at least Canada knows how I feel. So it's fine. It's fine. It's true.
Now, there is some question as to who actually leaked those off-the-record comments there, but you've worked in a White House before. When a president speaks about a close ally that way and basically says, I'm not gonna do any talking with them. I'm just going to kind of beat them over the head. Does that work in your view?
Not typically. And I think if we are suggesting this is a chess game of strategy from Trump and his team, I think we're giving him a little too much credit. I mean, what we saw announced on NAFTA earlier this month was just a small sliver of what needs to happen. I've been involved in trade agreements and trade negotiations as well, and there's a lot more that would need to happen in order for it to be finalized. In this particular case, I think it's also important to note, I worked with those Bloomberg reporters for 8 years in the White House. Never once did they violate anything I said off the record, anything President Obama said off the record. There's no way it comes from them, and that's what he accused them of. So there is a question as to whether this was somebody in the White House. The transcripts typically go around broadly, who wanted this information out for strategic reasons, for other reasons, or even whether it was Trump himself, because we're in bizarro land. So that's possible.
Karine, despite steps like this, in your view, is it possible that the president is overall, big picture, winning this argument here? Because the fact is that many of his voters, many working Americans, do feel that they got the short end of the stick on these trade deals, jobs leaving the country, et cetera.
But, Jim, there is no art of the deal. I mean, Donald Trump is very good at tearing things apart, the Iran deal, NAFTA, Paris climate deal, and he can't seem to fix them. He doesn't know how to fix them. And remember, he used to say he alone can fix it. But you don't see that. There's a reason why the Washington Post and ABC poll today showed him at 36%, because people are tired of the chaos, tired of the lies, you know, tired of the racism. They're tired of it all. And that's a terrible number for Republicans 2 months away from midterms, to be at 36 at approval rating for Donald Trump.
Quick thought, if you want it, Alpha, because those numbers are hard. 60% disapproval. 36% approval. Well, that disapproval is a high in the ABC Washington Post poll.
Well, that's one poll. If you took Real Clear Politics, that's at 43, 44%.
But I won't. It's below 43% out. It's at 42, which is not, to be frank, a great number for a president.
But it's been where he's been generally in the 40s. But aside from the numbers, I have to respectfully disagree with my friends here on the set. Is the president is doing precisely what he said he would do when he ran for president. He was against the Iran deal. I think had he backed away from that, then he'd be talking about how he was a hypocrite. He was talking about these trade deals need to be torn up and they need to be renegotiated. And they have been, we have been making progress. And I think the voters are recognizing that. So when you look at Donald Trump's record, Donald Trump is doing precisely what he said he would do. And I really do believe, I do really believe it's good to be firm with other, even with friends.